Okay, so I'm placing my phone on some CDs, and they're placed behind this phone, so I have to position it right. And once again, I'm just lazy, and I'm still wearing my pajamas. And the time right now is nearly 10 to 9 in the morning, and I have to leave the house by 10 past 11 due to my final music technology lesson, and tomorrow I have that music technology exam, and it's going to be the final one for me. So, yes, just good stuff. Anyways, why not do an album review? 2013 album review on the new Alice in Chains release entitled The Devil Put Dinosaurs Here. So, I know that a couple of my favourite people have reviewed it already. You know, you've got Chainsaw Gears 12, Midnight Strike 3625, Weekly Metal Reviews, Shadow Blade 9209. There will be more to come in the near future. So, yeah, if you don't know who Alice in Chains are, they are, in my opinion, quite a unique, interesting American rock band. Well, from their previous albums, like Facelift and Dirt, for examples, they are somewhat like rock mixed with grunge combined. Although that Dirt is their most successful release, and after the death of Layne Staley, their first vocalist from Heroin, Alice in Chains' lineup and musical style really changed for the most part, and they've brought in you know, some different members, and one of them is what's his name? Jerry Cantrell or Cantrell on vocals. If I pronounced that incorrectly, I'm sorry. So yeah, this is the follow-up to 2009's Black Gives Way to Blue, and which I enjoyed a lot, by the way. So this is their fifth studio album, and Capitol Records is the record label for the album, and it's 67 minutes long. So it's a pretty long, quite unique Alice in Chains album. So I was a person that I just find the band really interesting for what they do for their music. So for this album, it has 12 tracks, and surprisingly, most of these tracks of this album are at slow tempoed paces, and the song structures of this whole entire album are just, you know, really simple stuff, and I do not have anything wrong with that. I really like some simple music because simple music is sometimes, you know, really catchy and easy to follow, just good stuff basically. Like some examples of different bands, you know, some rock bands like you know, like AC/DC, you know, they are really simplistic with, you know, a lot of the same chords with really good, you know, guitar licks and solos here and there. And some metal bands, you know, like System of a Down from the albums like their debut, Toxicity and Steal This Album, they are crazy, yet, but a really good, simple-minded metal band until their creativity got a little bit better with Hypnotize and Mesmerize. So, yeah. So Alice in Chains, at this point of view, really had their music simple, and you know, I just have nothing wrong with that. I mean, if Alice in Chains really wanted to do that, that's fine by me. And you know, when it came out, it got positive reception, and it was just praised by the fans. Well, that's just obvious to say. So, Alice in Chains' music is mostly on a really different type of guitar tuning, and I think the tunings in the album are from like I think E flat or C sharp, Really don't know, but I bet it's the C sharp tuning. If it's incorrect, then tell me what tuning from the guitars that the band used for this album is. So these tracks are pretty much like long ones. They're from like 4 to 7 minutes long, and I really don't find the whole album, really dragging me down, slowing me down, and just they never really bore me with this album. Just some really good songs on here, for like the two singles for starters, Hollow and Stone, and other really good songs like Voices, Phantom Limb, Choke, and other really good songs on here. And the vocals from Jerry and also William Duvall are really good on this album, and they just really came up with this very very unique vocal style with range, and they really bring out the same styles from the old Alice in Chains' previous era. So, the vocals are really much like the band's previous releases, like Facelift and Dirt, and so on and whatnot. And Sean's drumming on this album is just, simple, really good stuff, and they're just there to keep everything in time and beat with some really good bass and drum fills combined. And the bass guitar work from Mike is another really good thing on the album, and it just sounds obviously like really low, and the sound of it is just really good, and the sounds of the electric guitars as well. Wow, I just really like the sound of them, and they are just really much like really thick and really raw sounding, and that's what I like about some of the band's creativity at times, because they're just really coming up with songs with very thick, interesting, raw, heavy sounds from the electric guitars, and just some really good unique style on vocals, and just some great songs on here. So the production as well is also really good, and the vocals, the sound of the vocals just sounded really clear, and they just really had to bring a lot of life into the music. And I've already mentioned the sound of the electric guitars. The drum sound is also really good as well. So, that's really all I've got to say about The Devil Put Dinosaurs here. And I'm going to add it to the top 25 of the year. So, and thank you guys for watching. And I will be back to do more of these 2013 reviews in the future. So, rock on.